Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video, I am going to discuss the principles of engineering watch for the subject engine watch keeping 1 for week 4. So this topic is referring to watch keeping on ships. I'm your instructor today, and let's get started. So this is your engine room machinery, and these people here are the engineers working in engine room machinery. Let us proceed. This topic is taken from the STCW, which is Standard Training Certification on Watchkeeping, under the competence, the table of competence. We have here the A, table A-3, is last one, function 1, chapter 1. Maintaining a safe engineering watch. And we have also here, table of competence, A-3, is last one, function 4, chapter 7, which is application of leadership and team working skills, taken from the IMO model course 1.39. So we have here our QOP. Table A-3 is last one, function 1, chapter 1, under the QOP 1. Thorough knowledge of principles to be observed in keeping an engineering watch. So we have here point 1 under this table. Under the knowledge, understanding, and proficiency, which is QOP, we have point 1 here, duties associated with taking over and accepting a watch. Routine, we have also here point 2, routine duties undertaken during a watch. And we have point 3, maintaining of machinery space logs and significance of the reading taken. And point 4, we have here the duties associated with handing over a watch. Next, we have table A, slash 1, function 4, chapter 7, under the QOP 1.2. Knowledge and ability to apply effective resource management on effective communication on board and ashore. So with that, we have our learning objectives. Learning objectives number 7, understand the general principles applying to engine watch keeping. Learning objectives number 8, define the term engineering watch. And learning objectives number 9, understand the watch system adapted in engine room. So, let us proceed. Understand the general principles applying to engine watchkeeping. So, taken from the STCW Engineering Watchkeeping Principles 2010 STCW Code and their Chapter 8 Standards Regarding Watchkeeping. Section A dash 8 is last to watchkeeping arrangements and principles to be observed. So part 3, watchkeeping principles in general. So we have here, it watches shall be carried out based on the following bridge and engine room resource management principles. So we have our number 1. Under this part 3 watchkeeping principles in general. Proper arrangement for watchkeeping personnel shall be ensured in accordance with situation. Any limitation in qualification or fitness of individuals shall be taken into account when deploying watchkeeping personnel. Understanding of watchkeeping personnel regarding their individual roles, responsibility, and team roles shall be established. So, in other words, proper arrangement for watchkeeping personnel. For example, let us give an example to the engine department. So the port engineer, the third engineer, and the second engineer. So the port engineer is being assigned to the watch from 12 to 4 in the afternoon and 12 to 4 after midnight. And then for the third engineer is assigned to the watch from 8 to 12 in the morning or 0800 hours to 1200 hours in the morning and 8 to 12 in the night or 2000 hours to 2400 hours in the night. So that is an example of proper arrangement for personal watchkeeping. And the chief engineer has to ensure in accordance with the situation. So the chief engineer also is not doing the watch, but he is 24/7 available, 24 hours a day and 7 days a week available for any call. So any problem from the engine room, the engineer on watch or the officer in charge of an engineering watch shall call the chief engineer for help and reporting. So next, limitation in qualification or fitness. Of course, that limitation shall be taken into account. For example, the engineer is not capable in doing the watch, so that situation should be addressed. So he should be knowledgeable in doing the watchkeeping, in doing the maintenance of the machinery for the safety of the crew, the safety of the property, which is the ship, and the safety of the environment. So, understanding watchkeeping. So, we have here the team roles and the roles of the individual. So, if you are an engineer You have the roles to perform in your respective duties. You have the roles. So you cannot do the job of the chief engineer because you are not being assigned in that the job of chief engineer as per your job description. But if some job of the chief engineer to be assigned to you, then to be supervised by the chief engineer or else the second engineer also. So you have different role. You have the role of a support engineer. You have assigned machinery, the third engineer, and chief engineer, and the overall is the chief engineer. You have different roles. So as a team, the chief engineer is has the higher role in the engine team, in the engine department. So next, we have number 4, the master, chief engineer officer, and officer in charge of duties, of watch duties, shall maintain a proper watch, making the most effective use of the resources available, such information, installation, equipment, and other personnel. So, master and chief engineer should maintain the proper watch by means of his subordinates, his engineers and his officers. So the chief engineer should, in the engine department, should ensure that the effectiveness of the watch is being implemented in the engine room machinery, as well as also the deck machinery if needed to be checked and maintained. So this master and chief engineer officer, they are bound to ensure that the watch is properly done in their respective department. So there should be an information. For example, such information is written in the engine control room that this is the time of your duties for engineer, third engineer, and the second engineer. So everything that is to be done in the engine room is either the watch keeping, the maintenance, the operation, is the reporting, the what we call the making the records to the logbox, then it should be done properly. It should be supervised by the master and the chief engineer. Master in the bridge and the chief engineer in the engine room. So this is your engine control room. So here on the right, here is the chief engineer, or either this is second engineer doing the maneuvering. And here also the engine rating is doing the reading. So everything is to be done properly. Define the term engineering watch. So we have here, watchkeeping personnel shall understand functions and operation of installation equipment and be familiar with handling them. So of course, watchkeeping personnel should be knowledgeable enough, strongly knowledgeable for handling machineries. So during his watch, for example, fourth engineer, third engineer, second engineer, he can increase and decrease the main engine as per order. He can start and stop diesel generator engine. He can also synchronize the or parallel the generator for reserve power. For example, the deck department is cooling that they will start the deck machinery. So you should check if there is enough power in the main switchboard. If not, then you can start, the engineer can start the other generator and parallel to have a reserve power to avoid blackout. The engineer also can maintain, do the maintenance, can repair, and can start and stop all the auxiliaries like pumps, freshwater generator, boiler, etc. He can start. So he should be knowledgeable to expansion and operation of that installation and equipment, that machine. Watchkeeping personnel shall understand information and how to respond information from each station and installation equipment. So for example, if there is a order from the deck department that you have to go to, for example, on the deck because the deck machinery is not working, so that engineer should understand how to respond that problem. Otherwise, if he cannot, he should inform the chief engineer. Information from the station installation equipment shall be appropriately shared by all the watchkeeping personnel. Of course, if there is a what we called the job slip from the previous watch and should be hand over to the next watch, there should be an information. Where is this job? Where is this equipment? Everything is done there. Is it complete or not? Should be, or if there is a trouble, should be what we called, should be hand over to the next watch so that there is no doubt and for the safety of the operation, there should be a information always. Watchkeeping personnel shall maintain and exchange an appropriate communication in any situation. Of course, that is very important, communication. Otherwise, if you have no communication, then you don't know that a machine has a trouble and it can lead to big problem, big trouble. So there should be a handover. So when you go down to engine room, at least 15 minutes in advance, so that there is a time for the handing over and taking over the watch. Watchkeeping personnel shall notify the master chief engineer officer in charge of the watch duties without any hesitation, with any doubt as to what action to take in the interest of safety. Of course, if you are engineering or you are the officer in charge of an engineering watch, if you have any doubt during your watch, you have to call your senior officer, which is the chief engineer, or on the deck department, which is the master or the captain of the ship. So without any hesitation, if you are in doubt, you have to call your superior. So for the interest of safety of the crew, the whole crew, and the safety of the property, which is the vessel, and the safety for the environment. So that is to be done during your watch. Understand the watch system adapted in engine room. So we have 12 ways to master the engine room watchkeeping procedure. So we have here, number one, knowledge is the base. So your basic knowledge, you should have a basic knowledge. So the first and most important step to enhance your duties during a watch is to have a very strong knowledge base. One must know the basics of the machines and their operations, new trends and upcoming technologies and maritime regulations along with their amendments. So you should have a basic knowledge of the operation of that machines and the maintenance. Because if you don't have no knowledge, then that is very dangerous. You either encounter a trouble and you cannot rectify, and then if there is a trouble and you don't know, that is that can affect the operation of the ship. So you are always allowed to call the chief engineer, but you have to use also your instinct, your knowledge. If you don't have that, then that is a big problem. So you must have a knowledge, a strong knowledge of the position that you are acting for. Follow your instincts. It is commonly said on ships that in order to become a good watchkeeper, an engineer must use all the six senses: touch, hearing, smell, visuals, taste, and kinesthetic senses. Six senses, all the senses, when applied correctly, help an engineer to understand the condition of machines in better way. So, example, touch. So, when you are doing the watch in the engine room, you have to touch the pipe, touch the machine, if it is already hot, beyond that normal temperature is already trouble. Remember, in doing logical troubleshooting, you have to recognize normal operation. So, a certain parameter is being applied to that machine, but more than the setting parameter is already you observe, then that is already trouble. Hearing, you can observe unusual sound, so you can use that hearing. Smell, you can smell burning. Probably there is burn parts of that machine, then you can use that smell. If you smell something that is burning, then you have to check. Visuals, you can use this visual inspection, visual round in the engine room, and you have found the vibration of the pipe, vibration of the pump, the engine, or leaking, etc. Then you can use this visual inspection. Test, for example, you test the fresh water is already contaminated with seawater, and then you can identify that is already contaminated with seawater. But do not drink. You only test if it is not contaminated. All these senses, when applied correctly, help an engineer to understand condition of machines in a better way. So we will start with touch. Feeling a machine for its temperature can tell you about the condition inside the machinery. For example, high temperature means something went wrong or something wrong. So, for example, I give you a real example. When I was a second engineer on ship, so I was the time on the watch, and when I touch the low oil pump of the aircon compressor number one was already too hot, so I cannot even put my hand in that part of that compressor in 5 minutes. So even in 2 minutes, I cannot put my hand there because already too hot. So I informed the chief engineer. I said, sir, this is already hot. This is not normal for me. But the chief engineer told me that I have the record from the fourth engineer and third engineer watch. By those from the laser, they took the reading. But I said, this is already abnormal for me. This is already hot. And this is not normal for me. So I'm doing the watch. For me, this is not normal. So the chief engineer ignored my opinion. So although I was right the time, so he ignored. So the machine was continue running, that air condition. So after 2 days, I was surprised that early morning, the fire alarm was sounded. And I immediately rushed to the engine room, to the boiler area, because it was very smoky, very foggy there, and I cannot see the boiler area. So I trace where is this the location of this fire. So I go down, I went down to the air condition room. So the what we call the aircon compressor number 1 was already totally burning. So I said to the chief engineer, sir, this is not normal anymore, but he still ran that particular air condition compressor. So by means of touch, I was able to check those machine by means of touch. So touch is important. Hearing, it is always advisable to keep a track of sounds coming from different machines in the engine room, as any abnormality would result in any change of the sound. So remember, as I always said, that logical troubleshooting is you have to recognize normal operation. So during normal operation role, you already recognize a normal sound of your machinery. But it so happened that your machinery, one of your machinery, has an abnormal sound during your watch. So you have to use this hearing to track that sounds. You have to check where is the sounds coming, because that is already abnormal. So that is already trouble. Smell, another powerful sense that helps to determine problems. Smell, burning of parts or accessories due to increase in temperature, oil leakage, chemicals, etc. can be easily identified using this sense. So now I give you an example. So as I said earlier, the air condition compressor was burning. So you can smell that this is burning. So already high temperature, oil leakage. I give you an example of oil leakage. So when I was a third engineer in a cruise ship, so during my watch, I there was smelling fuel oil, bunker fuel oil. So somewhere in boiler room. So that time I check, because I am on the watch in the engine room. So I check, and then I found out that the boiler area is already foggy and smoky, and I cannot see anything there. So I called the second engineer watch on the control room with the telephone. I said, there is fire in the engine room boiler area. So he said, please replace me here in the control room and I will check. So he check, he cannot see anything also. So we activate all the engineers to came down to engine room, and we look the trouble. we find the trouble. So I also reported that there is a contamination of fuel oil, bunker fuel oil, in the observation tank of the boiler. And there was also a splashing of the bunker fuel oil on the ceiling in that area and in the surrounding area. So we all engineers there, we check and we open the what we call the additional condenser. Then the temperature of the what we call the feed water of the boiler water was going down, and the foggy was also going down or was disappear. So we learned that after how many days, after 3 days, 4 days, we troubleshoot that problem. So I open all the steam trap of the fuel oil tank, and I cannot find anything that is leaking. So I remember one Filipino, a third engineer, doing the what we call cleaning of the fuel oil purifier heater, and he soaked with chemical. He submerged with chemical in 24 hours. After that, he rinsed and he installed back without the pressure testing. So one second engineer told me, please check that steam trap of that fuel oil purifier heater. Then I checked, then I found there that there was a lot of bunker fuel in the steam trap. So the leaking, the origin of the leaking is in the what we call the in the fuel oil purifier heater. So I use the smell. I smell in the engine room that I found there was something problem. So smell test, your tank can identify different tests, and you can apply this characteristic to your housekeeping routines. For example, testing can help to identify the difference between seawater and fresh water, as both of them are used as prime mediums for cooling on ships. So I will give you an example by the use of test. So during the last time, everybody was complaining, even me, to the chief cook that the rice is being cooked by the chief cook was already salty. So I check the fresh water was already salty, was contaminated with seawater. We check also all the drinking fountain and the supply water to the machinery, of course, the supply water to the drinking fountain. We check with the chloride tablet, and we prove that there is a contamination, a lot of contamination, and we drink also, we test a lot of seawater contamination in that fresh water. So by use of your test, you can identify if it is already fresh water, already contaminated with seawater. So we investigate, and we found out that in the computer, all the alarms was registering there, and we found out that the alarms is being disabled or reposed by the third engineer on watch. So the chief engineer warned him that do not do it again. The chief engineer make the report because that is not proper. So during his watch, he sleep on the watch, and he disabled the alarm in the fresh water generator, and the fresh water generator was producing high salinity of fresh water, and it contaminate to the freshwater to the freshwater tank. So you can use the test. Visual, the most commonly used sense of all is the power of visualization, helpful in identifying engine room and machinery condition. Whenever you enter the engine room, you must start looking for any kind of visual abnormality. So, of course, in doing the your engine room round watch, you use your visual or your seeing. You check visually during your engine room round. You check visually there if pipe is vibrating, pump is vibrating, engine is vibrating, or there's a leaking there, or there's a flooding there, or there's abnormal happening in your machinery operation. So by visual check, you will recognize if it is still normal or if it is in trouble. So for example, I have this attitude when doing the watch. So when doing the watch, all the pressure and temperature parameter there, when the machinery is in normal operation, I had right in my personal pocketbook. So that is my attitude when doing the watch. So I write. So this is normal. This is the parameter. This is the pressure. This is the temperature. This is the reading during normal. When the machine is in abnormal, is indifferent already in the pressures and temperatures, so that is already abnormal. So it so happened when I was a third engineer in a cruise ship. So from the other engineer, when they are doing the watch, there is no production of the freshwater generator. So he turned over to me when I'm doing the watch. Then I look all the parameters. There was the vacuum. There is no more vacuum. Very hot already the temperature of the chamber, and everything was abnormal already. As per my record here, is very different. So I check everything. The pipeline, I found out that the bulb was broken. So I rectify it during my watch, and the vacuum restored in a normal condition, and the production is increasing to normal. So by visual inspection, visual check, you can check if it is normal or abnormal. Sixth sense considered to be the most powerful of all senses. Your inner feeling, gut feeling, can sometimes prove to be lifesaver during watch keeping. Listen to it when you feel there is something wrong on the engine room. However, don't rely on it blindly. Back it up with proper procedures. Of course, you have a lot of procedures in the department in the engine room. You have to follow it. Follow the procedure in operation, in maintenance, in watch keeping, and you should have a good judgment whenever it is needed. So always follow the procedures, how to do your watch, how to maintain your machinery, assign machinery, procedure for recording, procedure for reporting. You should do the proper procedure. So go by the book. Every engine room is provided with hundreds of documents, manuals, operating instruction, and safety and pollution prevention instruction, just to name a few. Follow them religiously during your watch keeping during your watch keeping procedure. So for example, you are doing the watch keeping, you should follow what is there in the SMS manual or safety management system manual. Should follow in doing your duties. In doing your maintenance, you should follow the instruction manual, the maker's manual. Do not touch the machinery without reading that maker's manual, because if something is forget, your machinery will be broken, will be leaking, or what we call there is a trouble will happen. So I will give you an example. My port engineer, he overhauled already twice the feed pump of thermal oil boiler. So after he overhauled, it's still leaking, always leaking of oil. So I said overhaul it again, and the mechanical seal is almost consumed because of that overhaul. So without, because he thought that he's already master, because he already done that the job. But I said, why not checking what is in the instruction manual? So another chief engineer was joined on board. Then I instructed to overhaul. So I was checking the time when he's overhauling, and he also is still not using the instruction manual. So when I check the instruction manual, there was missing part there, which is the O-ring, that part. I said, here in the manual there is an O-ring, but in your pump that is that you dismantle and what we call a symbol, there is no O-ring. So there should be an O-ring there. So I put an O-ring there, then the leaking was gone, no more leaking. So you should follow the instruction manual always. And when it comes to operation, when it comes to maintenance, and for the safety also, and for pollution of the pollution prevention of environment. So you should follow those procedure to avoid or to prevent the problem. Interpreting logbook. A smart engineer would know the importance of engine room logbook and would also know how to interpret previous readings of different machines from the same. Interpreting log means keeping a track of previous records of machinery parameters from the logbook and using them to analyze the present situation or to identify a problem. So, for example, the logbook, there was a trouble. There was a trouble of the main engine. Turbocharger of the main engine in my previous ship when I was acting as chief engineer. So I investigate the problem by the use of the engine room logbook. So from 2009 until 2015, the problem was still the same. So on my first contract on that ship, the problem was not gone, was not rectified, and then I studied logbook. They cannot give full RPM or full speed because of the surging of the main engine turbocharger. So when I was always doing the maintenance of the turbocharger, cleaning the turbine blade, I found out that there was always a accumulation of carbon. So that caused the turbocharger surging. So I mentioned to I made a lot of report, a lot of troubleshooting, but still the problem was not being rectified. Then one time I mentioned to the superintendent, and he said probably the timing of the injection pump. So by the days of the logbook, I know that there was a problem long time ago already. So the superintendent called the attention of the chief engineer on the sister ship, which because that was a sister ship, the same engine, the same machinery, so the same size of ship. So he said, he asked the chief engineer there on the sister ship that please check the timing of your, please check and read the timing of your main engine, injection pump, and send it to me. So the superintendent sent to me that record, then I retiming the injection pump, and then the result was very effective. The turbocharger, what we call surging, was gone. So I can put the RPM in the full RPM 100% or more than. So by interpreting the logbook, that is very important. Clear communication. Efficient communication between maritime professional is an important factor for safe and efficient operation on board. So if you are a watch keeper, you must clearly communicate all kinds of operations and problems suspicious with your seniors, so communicate all kinds of operation and problem suspicious with your seniors and crew members. So clear communication is very important. So if you have a problem, if there's a problem, if there's a trouble, if there's a fault, operation fault, during your watch, you must immediately, without hesitation, communicate with your senior officer and the crew members. Otherwise, if they are remains blind to that problems, and there is no safety during their watch also. So you must inform everything that you find that there is a problem on your machinery. So communication is important. So for example, when I was doing a training, so we have a case study, and the case study was the tanker ship was run aground because the engine was automatically shut down when the engine was navigating. So there was an alarm that high temperature of cooling water, because there is a ship, especially new ship, the sophisticated system ship, the automation ship, has a lot of protection of the machinery, protection alarm. So there was an alarm high temperature of the fresh water, cooling water, and they cannot rectify the engineers. So in the absence, the fault there is the absence of the communication that to the bridge, that nobody called to the bridge to reduce the RPM of the main engine, to reduce also the what we call the temperature of the cooling water. So if somebody called to the bridge to reduce, then the temperature will go down, then the main engine will not shut down automatically. So clear communication is very important. Also, for example, in bunkering, if the communication is lack of proper communication, then very dangerous to have that oil spill during the bunkering. So communication is very important. Take a complete round. Don't skip any machinery. Automation and alarm system of machines are always helpful in detecting early stage faults. However, it is also a known fact that human vigilance is a more capable of detecting and interpreting errors more accurately. So, when on engine room round, all machines on all levels must be examined for proper operation. Moreover, also make sure that you note your findings in the logbook for future reference. So this means when you are doing the engine room round watch from the economizer area down to the lower deck of the engine room, all the machinery there should be checked when doing the watch, and any abnormalities should be recorded for future reference. Any parameters that is already out of limit should be recorded, and also you have to report to your chief engineer. Never neglect any alarm. Alarm system in the engine room are in an indication or pre-warning of any abnormality in engine room machines. Sometimes due to a technical glitch such as a connection or electronic fault, an alarm would become faulty and give out audio and visual warnings after every few minutes. So for example, by the vibration of the ship, by the bad weather, the ship has a lot of vibration, and then there is a terminal, the what we call the electrical wiring was lost, then it gives a lot of alarm, and the engineer should not neglect that alarm. It should be rectified and reported to the chief engineer. And then I give you a real example. When I was an acting chief engineer on board, my second engineer, my third engineer and fourth engineer was Russian. So during their watch, I found out that they put a toothpick in the push button of the acknowledged alarm. So there is no alarm anymore in engine room because they put a toothpick there, and the alarm cannot be activated because the alarm system is already in an open circuit. So I took a camera and I took picture as evidence, and I warned those engineer that never do it again because alarm is very important. If there is an alarm, it is indication of or pre-warning of abnormality in the engine room machines. So you know that there is a problem because there is an alarm. So if it is an alarm every few minutes, then you have to rectify that alarm. You can either call the electrician. If there is no electrician, then who are assigned the electrician is to rectify that alarm. So do not hide faults. If you see any kind of faults while taking rounds or have committed a mistake, never try to hide it. Remember that even the smallest fault can become dangerous if unattended at the correct time. Always report to the incident to your superiors, to your chief engineer, and try to remove or repair the fault as soon as possible. So this is the problem now if you hide the problem. So if you hide a small problem, if there is a trouble, and then you did not report to the superior, it will become a big trouble in due time. So you have to report even if it is small trouble to prevent to become a big trouble, the big fault to prevent the damage of that certain machine. So never hide faults. You should be honest always in reporting so that it can be rectified immediately. So never hide faults or trouble. Call for help when in need. In an engine room having hundreds of machines, faults are bound to happen. Sometimes you may feel that the fault is a big and a single person won't be able to handle it alone. So in such situation, don't hesitate to ask for help. Ship operation is all about teamwork. And you should respect that and know its importance. So this is very important, the teamwork. Teamwork of the engine department, teamwork of the deck department, and teamwork of the whole ship crew department, the whole ship. So, for example, there is during your watch, there is a flooding in the engine room. So, and you cannot stop the leaking, so you can't stop the seawater, so you should call the attention of the chief engineer, and the chief engineer will call the attention of his whole department, and also to the deck department, also the master, and the duty on watch, he should call the attention that there is flooding in the engine room. So, those emergency response team will respond immediately, rush to engine room to rectify, to help that flooding. So in that situation, you call the attention of the every crew. So call for help when in need. Call for help when in need. So, for example, so during your watch, you have a trouble in machinery and you cannot rectify, call immediately the chief engineer. Obey orders. A good watchkeeper must follow eligible orders from seniors who have better experience and understanding of machines. However, a smart watchkeeper should also use his or her own judgment when the need arises. Take inputs and advice from your seniors, but be confident while carrying out your duties. So, during the night watch, the chief engineer make an night order in night order book. So you have to read that as engineer on watch. You have to read that and you have to sign, and then you have to follow that order what is written there. So obey every orders from your officers. The eligible, meaning eligible order, not illegal. The order that is in line with your duties, not orders that is illegal, you should not obey. For example, your senior officer will tell you, okay, bring a hose here, we will discharge this oily water overboard by not passing the 15 ppm. So do not obey that one. That is not eligible orders. So you have a proper judgment when the need arises. So if uh, you are in doubt, so you have to ask your senior officers, take input from them, because they are qualified and experienced engineers, senior officer. So you have to be also confident while carrying out your duties. Follow alcohol policy. Never ever commence or carry out your watch under the influence of alcohol, as it may interfere with your decision making abilities. Always follow your company alcohol policy. In this case, you are under influence of alcohol, or in case you are under influence of alcohol, don't be ashamed to inform your seniors. So, we have in the company, we have what we call alcohol, company alcohol policy. So this is a heavier ground for you to be repatriated if you violate this company alcohol policy. So you can be repatriated if you drink alcoholic beverages when you are doing the watch. So never ever do your watch when you are under influence of alcohol, because it may interfere or may destroy your abilities of the decision making to make decision in a right decision instead of wrong decision when you are doing a watch. For example, there is already a trouble in engine room, but since you are under influence of alcohol and you cannot think to rectify that trouble, you cannot even call the chief engineer. So it is a breach of safety to the crew, to the property, which is the ship, and to the environment. Avoid fatigue. Fatigue is the biggest reason behind the human mistakes on ship. So we can hear always that human error, 80% of the accident is caused by human error. So if you are over fatigued, then that is a cause also of human error. So always take a proper rest in your free time and avoid working when tired. Through this is tough to follow the most of the time, ask your seniors for the brief break so that you can freshen up and get back to work with more energy and enthusiasm. So avoid over fatigue, because if you are over fatigue, you cannot perform your duties and responsibilities properly, like your watch. Probably you sleep on the watch because you are over fatigued. Probably you cannot decide properly what to do because you are over fatigued, and you cannot also do the maintenance of your assigned machinery because you are over fatigued. So it can also affect to your health. So for example, the banking operation and the maneuvering operation needs a lot of time. So if you are working more than that working hours, then the next day you should have a compensatory period. The engineer, the chief engineer should, or the master should consider and arrange that on the next day you should sleep to compensate that compensatory period that you are working in a long hours, to avoid that avoid fatigue or the over fatigue, so that you can be refreshed again, and you can work with energy and enthusiasm, and you are happy with your work or with your job. So we have here described the man engine room and its operation. So when the machinery space are in the man condition, the officer in charge of an engineering watch shall at all times be readily capable of operating the propulsion plant, propulsion equipment, in response to the needs for changes in the direction of speed. So for example, the bridge department, the bridge is ordering to reduce or to increase the RPM the engine. The engineer on watch can increase or decrease. Or for example, the deck department is calling, ordering that they have to start the deck machinery. You should check the your main switchboard if there is enough power. Otherwise, if not, then you show you, the engineer on watch can should or can start the second generator and can parallel to have a reserve power to avoid blackout, to avoid overload. So the engineer also should be able to do the recording and the reporting, and he should be able also to operate and maintain the associated machinery, all the auxiliary machinery, as he is being assigned. So further from that, the engineer also in no doubt should everything should be he should have knowledge in the operation and the function of the machinery and the maintenance of the machinery in order for the ship operation of the ship of the ship. So next we have here describe the man machinery, the unmanned machinery space UMS, and its operation, or this is called unattended machinery spaces. So when the machinery spaces are in the periodic unmanned condition, the designated duty officer in charge of engineering watch shall be immediately available and on call to attend the machinery space. So UMS or unattended machinery spaces is a marine automation system for ships engine room. So if there is a malfunction in any machinery, an alarm will be sounded in the engine room, as well as the on-duty engineer's cabin. So it's the engineer's duty go down in the engine room and investigate the alarm. So this is your engine control room, and this is your alarm. So visual alarm and audio alarm. So you have here the siren, and then when the engine room is unmanned in the night, the engineer on watch is in the cabin. So for example, because I work boat, I work the also with the unattended machinery space or UMS Bisel, and I work also before in man engine room. So if there is a requirements because the money the unmanned engine room, there is no duty engineer in engine room at the night. So there is a requirements that we have to fill out the checklist in unmanned engine room. So we do the, so when I was second engineer at the time, we do the 1 hour engine room round from 2100 to 2200, and then we fill out the checklist. We do the complete round in the whole engine room, starting from the top, from the economizer area down to the lower deck of the engine room. So all the machinery is being checked. So here, if there is an alarm, so in engine room, if this gear is an alarm, so this is a dead man alarm here. And if this is gear only, if there is gear on what we call the, this is a combination of the machinery alarm and the dead man alarm. So sometimes this is separate. The dead man alarm is separate to the engine alarm or machinery alarm. So if this is here illuminating and there's an audio sounded, so this is, if the alarm is not rectified immediately after 2 to 3 minutes, or sometimes it is 2 to 5 minutes, and in my seat before, it is I think it was 11 minutes, but it is too long. Set the time that if you cannot rectify the alarm, if you not check in that minute, certain time is there is an emergency alarm, general alarm sounded in the whole ship. So everybody is awake. So that time, in my watch, when I was a second engineer, so there was an alarm in my cabin because I was doing the watch, the cabin watch. Then I went down to engine room. Then I rectify the alarm. So I forgot to the time to switch the selector switch to man engine room. So when I'm rectifying the alarm, there was an alarm sounded, the general alarm, so everybody was awake. So the chief engineer called me, the third mate on duty called me, the port engineer was going down to engine room, so because of the general alarm. So I forgot the time to switch off to man engine room. So after you rectify the alarm, you should switch on again to unmanned engine room. So every alarm there, because this is automated ship, automated system, will have an alarm to duty engineer cabin, and will have also an alarm to chief engineer cabin. So that is an attended machinery space. Nobody or no engineer in engine room during the night. It is left unattended, and it is being monitored by your alarm system, automation system. If there is an alarm, the engineer will go down to the engine room. So I like this system, this unmanned system, because I can do a lot of maintenance, because every engineer has is the work and can do a lot of maintenance. So I really like the UMS ship. So when I was a second engineer, I really like to work with UMS ships rather than man engine room. So I don't want to go on board with that unmanned engine room when I was a second engineer. So when I was a chief engineer already, so I come back to man engine room. So because I have a hard time to sleep when I'm working in the man engine room. So in the unmanned engine room, I can sleep. Even I can sleep 6 hours, and then I am again comfortable, so I can make also a lot of maintenance. So your unattended your this one, if there is a malfunction in any machinery, an alarm be sounded in the engine room as well as in the duty engineer's cabin. So that is an automated ship. So it's very important that your alarm system in a automated ship is working properly. So the fire alarm, machinery alarm, CO2 alarm, this is a combination of dead man alarm. So dead man alarm meaning if you cannot go down to engine room immediately after a certain minutes, then the dead man alarm will sound, and then followed by the general alarm. And this is the telephone alarm, visual alarm, and audio alarm. And this is the telegraph alarm while maneuvering. And this is a gas alarm. For example, there is a leak of gas. This is fire alarm. And this is here CO2 alarm. And you have here the lifeboat trail alarm or abandoned ship alarm here. So everything you can see and hear here, because this is fitted, this is working by the automation system. So here, this is the end of this discussion for this week. So I should conduct a class oral session during this discussion, but since this is recorded discussion, so I will schedule it later in the next meeting, and I will conduct also a quiz 3 for this week. So thank you for watching in this video discussion. Please don't forget to click subscribe. Please don't forget to click notification button, click like and share, and give a comment below. Thank you for watching, and see you on my next video.